America, you got too much stuff. Let me tell you, I'm a real estate agent. Every real estate agent will let you know you have too much stuff. You've saved for too long. And trust me, I mean, I don't want to go rifling through your stuff and tell you what a mistake you're making by keeping or moving any of this stuff, because I've done it myself. I lived in a house for nearly 20 years. And you just don't know where any of this stuff comes from, but suddenly you've got a house full of stuff. Crap. So you got to have a tough talk with yourself and make sure you're just not emotionally attached to an experience you had with this stuff or a price you paid for. It doesn't matter if you paid $400 for whatever the widget is. $400 was too much then. It's too much now. Nobody wants to reimburse you for it. There's no way to recover it. You need to become at peace with it and not have your stuff own you. It owns you when you're moving it around. And I'm dealing with this with a lot of people. A lot of folks have lived in their home for several years or more. A lot of older folks who, you don't know it. You don't know when the music's going to stop. You don't know when you're going to be too ill to get rid of your stuff. You don't know when you're going to lose a spouse. You don't know when you're going to whatever, have your kids sweep you up and take you back up north. You've got to start going through your stuff. And nobody better than Linda. Linda in Ledyard, Connecticut, with her 365 group, every day, open a drawer and get rid of something. You know, send it away to the Goodwill, throw it away. If it's broken, chipped, whatever. If it's that $400 widget and you haven't used it for several years, you're not going to use it. You're attached to the money. You're attached to the wife or husband you were with when you bought it. So, you know, I hate to go off on our junky lives, but you know, I'm one of the end users of your junk, and I have to walk into homes with people and have very tough talks and get them to box stuff up. And you know, do you want to pay somebody money to move a $400 widget or whatever your $400 or $1,000 or whatever it is? Are you going to pay somebody to move it? It's already cost you money. It's cost you money to store it. And now it's going to cost you money to move it where you're not going to use it again. Ugh. I probably have had 3 households in the last 2 weeks where I'm just stunned by the amount of stuff and, you know, having to negotiate with people. My first negotiation is really what to do with the stuff in the house to make it present well enough for a buyer to even want to cross your threshold. You have to have photos, and the photos have to not be overwhelming and cluttered. So, boy, if you don't know how to get rid of it or how to start parsing what's important in your life, I've got some great names and phone numbers of people who deal specifically with people who are overwhelmed with stuff. Professional organizers that can help you save the things that are precious, release the things to other people. If it was so special for you, let them help you find somebody that is going to think it's special too, and help you lighten up your load, lighten up your life, and create a space for more good things to come. Because if there's no room in your life for good things to get in there, they won't come your way. And that's it. That's my word of advice for a happy Sunday afternoon.